Loan borrowers are often confused why a major portion of EMI goes to interest and not the principal in initial period of the loan. Is the bank trying to make me pay more interest? Is the bank cheating me? Why is such a big amount allocated to interest and not the principal? These are the most common thoughts that come to a borrower who is a layman. His thoughts are justified as he doesn't know how the EMI gets divided between interest and principal. There can be two reasons for this. He has never asked the logic, or he has asked the rationale behind bifurcation, but the banker has failed to explain the same to him. The good news is that there is no rocket science involved behind the division of EMI into interest and principal. It's just a simple math. Let us first understand what is EMI. EMI stands for Equated Monthly Installments. It is the amount that the borrower has to pay equally every month throughout the tenure of loan, such that the loan balance at the end of the tenure of the loan becomes zero. Assuming that the borrower wouldn't make any prepayments during the period of loan. Why is there a need to calculate EMI? Suppose you take a loan. Can you repay the loan as per your own whims and fancies? The answer is a big no. Banks do not have a system to handle so many complex transactions where each borrower can repay the loan as per his or her convenience. So it is important for banks to arrive at a figure which borrower can pay equally every month so that the loan amount gets repaid within the tenure of the loan. So how is the EMI amount arrived at? There is a slightly complex mathematical formula involved in calculation of EMI amount. You don't need to manually calculate the EMI using the formula, as there are a lot of calculators available online where you just have to enter the value of principal, the rate of interest per annum and tenure, and you get the EMI automatically. The formula for EMI is, here P stands for the loan amount or the principal, R is the interest rate per month. If interest rate per annum is 11%, then rate of interest per month will be 11% divided by 12. N is the number of monthly installments. The above mentioned formula gives you the amount which needs to be paid equally every month so that your loan gets over at the end of tenure of the loan, assuming you wouldn't make any prepayments during the course of the loan. For example, let's assume that loan amount is rupees 25 lakh, the rate of interest is 11% and the tenure of loan is 20 years. So P is equal to 25 lakhs, R is equal to rate of interest per month is equal to interest, annual interest divided by 12 is equal to 11% divided by 12. N is equal to 240 months. In the formula, N is the number of months. So 20 years mean 240 months. Applying the above formula, EMI will come to rupees 25,805 rounded off. Now that we know the calculation of EMI, let's understand the bifurcation of EMI between interest and principal. The formula of EMI calculates EMI in such a way that at least the interest portion of every month gets covered fully in EMI, and principal amount gets divided over a period of loan in such a way that the borrower has to pay a fixed amount every month, that is EMI. The bifurcation of EMI into interest and principal is called amortization. Now let's go back to our same example. Let's understand the bifurcation now. The bifurcation happens in the following manner. First month. Loan amount outstanding at the beginning of first month is equal to rupees 25 lakh, which is the original loan amount. Interest for the first month is equal to 11% of rupees 25 lakh divided by 12 is equal to rupees 22,917. 11% is the interest per annum. So to get interest for 1 month, we need to divide the annual interest by 12. The EMI arrived as per mathematical formula of EMI is rupees 25,805, out of which rupees 22,917 is the interest. The balance amount, that is rupees 2,888, will go towards the principal. Balance amount is equal to EMI minus interest for the month is equal to rupees 25,805 minus rupees 22,917 is equal to rupees 2,888. The principal portion of EMI is always equal to EMI minus the interest for that particular month. So the first month's breakup of EMI into interest and principal is as follows. EMI is equal to rupees 25,805, interest is equal to rupees 22,917, principal is equal to rupees 2,888. Balance amount remaining after deducting interest of the first month from EMI of the first month is rupees 2,888. The loan amount outstanding at the end of the first month is equal to loan amount outstanding at the beginning of the first month minus principal repaid in the first EMI is equal to rupees 25 lakh minus the principal portion of the first EMI is equal to rupees 25 lakhs minus rupees 2,888 is equal to rupees 24,97,112. Second month, the loan amount outstanding at the beginning of the second month is equal to the loan amount outstanding at the end of the first month is equal to rupees 24,97,112. In the second month, the interest will be calculated on rupees 24,97,112 and not rupees 25 lakh. This is because the loan balance at the beginning of second month is rupees 24,97,112. So interest for second month is equal to 11% of rupees 24,97,112. The whole divided by 12 is equal to rupees 22,890. The EMI amount is rupees 25,805, which will be the same for entire tenure of the loan. So balance amount of rupees 2,915 will go towards the principal. The balance of rupees 2,915 is arrived as follows. EMI minus interest for second month is equal to rupees 25,805 minus rupees 22,890 is equal to rupees 2,915. So the second month's EMI breakup will be as follows. EMI is equal to rupees 25,805. Interest for second month is equal to rupees 22,890. Principal, that is the balance amount, is equal to rupees 2,915. The loan amount outstanding at the end of second month is equal to principal balance at the beginning of second month minus principal portion of the second EMI is equal to rupees 24,97,112 minus the principal portion of the second EMI is equal to rupees 24,97,112 minus rupees 2,915 is equal to rupees 24,94,197. Third month, loan amount at the beginning of the third month is equal to the loan amount outstanding at the end of second month is equal to rupees 24,94,197, which we have just calculated. In the third month, the interest will be calculated on ₹24,94,197, which is outstanding loan amount at the beginning of the third month. So interest for the third month is equal to 11% of ₹24,94,197 divided by 12 is equal to 22,863. EMI for each month is ₹25,805. Hence, the principal portion of third month's EMI is equal to ₹25,805 minus ₹22,863 is equal to ₹2,941. If you continue bifurcating EMI for 20 years in this manner, you will find that each month the interest portion of EMI keeps on decreasing and the principal portion keeps on increasing. This is because loan amount outstanding is highest in the first month and then it keeps on reducing. Since the outstanding loan amount keeps on reducing after payment of each EMI, the interest portion of EMI also keeps decreasing. EMI, however, will remain the same for the entire tenure, and the amount of principal at the end of 20th year will become zero. This is how the EMI is bifurcated between interest and principal. Having gone through this, now you don't need anyone to explain to you why in the initial period the major portion of EMI goes towards the interest. Do you?